Good evening, everybody. Today I'm going to discuss about what is the best investment. Like, you know, whether should you buy apartment in a city or buy land in a land, pure land, right? So, again, before I start, because it's investment decision, I'm not an investor advisor. I'm just agriculture and food engineer. I covered in a just video before how investment companies or company fool you into investing in share market, right? So I have worked in a lot of investment banks and financial institutions like Morgan Stanley, RBS, NatWest, Ulster, Standard Life, Citibank, Deutsche Bank, Metro Bank, IFC, World Bank, Zurich Insurance, Eric Insurance. Certainly that doesn't make me an expert. I have 20 years. Again, that doesn't make me expert. I minted £1 million in last 10 years. Obviously, that also doesn't make me an expert. So use your own judgment, right? Conflict of interest. I have to remind you, there is a conflict of interest. We work to save the world. Our job, let me get you this guy. This is a huge loser list. So one of the our main realities, we somehow want to save humanity. And I need $1 trillion, like, you know, to finish the global warming. I need to plant a trillion tree. So I need $1 trillion. So that's a conflict of interest. Like, it's a 100-year plan, and unfortunately, world doesn't have 100 years. So what I am thinking of, instead of I generating $1 trillion, I will help million of you earn $1 million, a pound, right? Whatever way, and hopefully generate $1 trillion in 10 years, making a million millionaires in the process. Okay, some billionaires as well, depend on who you are, right? How much money can you can invest. Again, you have to take your own advice. You have to make your own judgment. Okay, so our advice to begin with is, I feel that land value, apartment value in a city, or houses will drop by 1 to 3% every year, 2 to 3% every year, and land value will increase similarly 2 to 3% every year. So the city value will keep going down, and the land value will keep going up, right? So we're talking about right now land rate usually around £2 to £3 per foot, and city value usually £2,000 to £3,000 per foot. They will meet somewhere. That the city value will go down and this will keep going up, and probably they should meet into £20 to £30. There's a chance that it could go to £200 to £300, so 100 times increase as well is a possibility. Because, and we will discuss the reason why I feel that the city has lost its luster. Right, let's see. First of all, yeah, if you are doing a job, it makes sense to stay in city, right? If you're doing a job in city, you're already in a high risk category. So it makes sense to stay in a city than go somewhere else, travel, which is more riskier. So if you're doing a job in a city, right, city center, just say this next door, because that way you're reducing the chance of catching your COVID disease, because you're traveling less, because traveling is where most of the viruses and you will get infection. And staying close, you can avoid the traffic. You don't have to do so. That's why it saves you a lot of time, money and time, and you make the big bucks, you know. So that's way. So that's the only exception I will add. If you are in a permanent visa or permanent citizen, that only makes sense, because otherwise you may be kicked out of the country anytime and it becomes a lot difficult. I have personal experience, which I'm going to discuss, like what happens if you're managing remote, and I'm going to talk about, I deal with property. I have around 10 apartments, 10 houses, 100 farm plots. So I have a huge amount of experience there. So if you see, the city is unsustainable. Like, take London example. 50% of the people don't earn enough to even afford living in London. They live on begging. Like, we call it grant, we call it government thing, welfare, whatever. But at the end of the day, it is begging. If you depend on somebody else's money to survive, it is nothing but begging. And yes, don't get me wrong, I'm also for that anybody who needs anything. And if you are any one of those, if you need any money, any help, feel free to ask. I'm also on, so don't get me wrong, but if you beg, it's still called begging. I will want you to earn on your own. So London is just unsustainable for most of the people. Okay, not for 10% of the people, but for 90% of the people, it's unsustainable. They cannot afford to live in London. They live outside. So it's unsustainable. I will come to the reason why it has become unsustainable. Most people in, like, say, is it only London? Okay, let's take about Bombay. Even more horrible. Horrible. One people sharing 10 bath. One bathroom is shared by 100 people. Horrible, pathetic living condition. Most Bombay. Again, it is most Bombayites, maybe 90% again, 10% still live, maybe 50%. But again, it's horrible living condition. Even if you earn a lot of money, like 90%, right? 50,000 rupees a month. It's a huge, you can live like king in India for 5,000 rupees a month. Even if you earn 50,000 rupees in Bombay, you will still live like beggars. So it has become unsustainable. There's more crime in city. Because of these problems, there are more people in stress. Because more people are in need of money. Because obviously everything is very expensive in city. So that means it increases the crime rate. And again, you deserve, your children need space. You need space. You don't want, you're not born to live in a matchbox size apartment. My ideal is every person need 1500 square feet of land, 500 living space and 1000 open space like this. That's my, you can do with less, but it's okay, you know, at least 1500 square feet per person. You deserve the space. Why are you, if you have to live like beggar, what is the point of earning? If your children have to live like beggar, what's the point of you earning? Give them the space they need. If children are getting hooked up to mobile, TV, and you blame them, you're killing your own children, you're killing your own self. For what? For losing money? So think about a practical advantage of having more space for yourself. Jobs. So earlier, jobs were in within the city. Now the jobs have moved out of city because city is too expensive. Like, take for example, I was running office in Bombay. Like, I still have offices in Bombay. And then I moved to Mandsaur, a small city. And then I moved to a farm. The reason? To sit one people in Bombay, it costed me 5 lakhs. In Mandsaur, for 5 lakh, I can sit 10 people. So it costs 10 times less office cost, even 10 to 100 times less office cost. It makes sense. Like, you don't have space to run factories. So you cannot open a factory, you cannot open, do anything in a city. There's literally no space left to do any commercial activity in city. That's why most of the job has moved out of city. There's still office job, but that is coming. Like, we can automate any work done in office can be done automatically by computer. It's coming, it's written. That's why we are seeing lot of job losses. Oh, yeah, IT automation, we are getting a lot of money, right? But any other folks which uses computer can be easily automated. Any work which is done in office can easily be automated. If you're a manager, I can automate you. I can replace you. Better manager, more efficient, no prejudice. Yeah, and again, you will say, why not have, so it makes sense to grow perishable in city, but it makes no sense to not open, make a chips packet in a city. That makes no sense to open a chips factory in a city. So I already covered how stock market failure pushes up. Like, this is all financial trick, right? We have already covered. Pollution is killing a lot of people. The other reason, I have another video which covers that fact. I'm not going to make this video. It's already getting too long. Chemical preservatives are killing people again, are causing cancer. I'm not going to cover. I have other videos which has covered that. So there's a 99% chance that if you stay in a city, it will kill you. Okay, forget about the financial thing. So first of all, it makes no sense for business sense to operate in a city. Now it makes no sense to live in a city. Now think about this guy, right? So where do you expect high growth? So I'll take example, which again, I'm going to take example from what I have seen. I have bought land. As I said, I bought office. I built a 100 people office in Mandsaur. So that land was bought for 5 rupees 30 years ago, maybe 30, 40 years ago, 5 rupees per foot. I bought it for 500, 100 times rise in 30, 40 years. Now the value is 500 rupees per foot. In 10 years, my land has gone from 500 rupees per foot to 5,000 rupees per foot. So what is a high growth area? It's the growing cities, not the big cities. Big cities, there's no growth. Companies are moving out to where? Medium to small size growth. But if you stay there, it makes sense, because the problem with a small city is it's not safe. Your land could be taken by somebody else, and it's next to impossible to get rid of. In UK, in India, like if somebody takes over your land, it's next to impossible to get rid of them. Or it's a huge financial burden. So unless you stay in a small city, it makes no sense to invest there. So what will you invest on? You buy land wherever you're staying or wherever it is safe. I'm here in UK, but I have land in India. I buy land in India. I still operate a lot in India, like 90% of my business still runs in India. I have CCTV, infrared cameras, everything. So you could use technology to manage the land. It's difficult to manage city space because city is very congested. Now they can cut off in land, you can do a lot, and that's another advantage of land. So we talked about how 5 rupees land per foot became, similarly, I will talk about another land, like, which is again my farms. I have land in my farms. The neighbor, he bought a land for 75 lakhs, which came to us as well, but we didn't have that much money that time. And he sold it for 25 crores because what he did, he plotted it up. So he converted 75 lakhs to 25 crores. Such thing is possible in city? No, it's not possible. It can only happen if you are in a remote area and you have land. There is a chance that there's a city coming. Maybe there's a chance that you can change the land category, and bingo, the land value jumps 10 times, 100 times. It cannot happen in city anymore, especially big city. Did I make money with city? Yes, I did make money city. Like, I bought apartment in Bombay for 16, 17 lakh and I sold it for 134 lakhs. It's around 10 times jump in 10 years. But those days are gone. The growth in Bombay has plateaued. In fact, I sold that apartment for 134. I bought another one for 128. In fact, higher means... the value in apartment which I did this magic fell by 20 lakhs. And again, both is my dealing. I sold the house, I bought the house just upstairs. So, and I bought it for 20 lakhs cheaper. And I have a business reason why I still need a place in Bombay, because my company is still registered in Bombay. But as I said, unless, and it makes no sense, like it still makes sense to buy apartment in if you're working in in London or New York, like city, but it makes no sense to buy in Bombay specifically, because Bombay you can get like the mortgage itself will be 101 lakh rupees, whereas you can get the same apartment on rent for 25,000 rupees. So even if you're working in a big city in India, it makes no sense, because rent is dirt cheap in India. So it makes no sense to buy an apartment in big cities in, or in any city in India. All you need to buy land in. Any other example? Let me see. I talked about high growth. So let me talk about the... So there was a crash, housing market bust, right? You know, heard about that. So I bought in that midst, I bought an apartment in USA. It costed me $260,000. After 12 years, I bought it in 2008, and after 12 years, the value is 220. So it lost $40,000 in 12 years. And you can see the slide, right? It's UK escaped that housing bust, right? Because obviously UK is the financial capital, and obviously financial people do more tricks And of course, they have more backbone to don't let the crisis, because they can just keep funding it. The governments are paying a lot of money to keep make sure that the crash doesn't happen. But what I feel, like, as COVID has made people very scientifically capable. It makes no sense to live in a city. We've seen that. We've seen that it makes no sense to do business in a city, because you can do it 10 times, 100 times cheaper in land. And probably every building in a city will see a death. And it's not good to stay in a house, a building which has a death. Especially if you know about it, it's very psychologically depressing. It reduces the value of life. Right? A building which has a death, do you want to own an apartment like that? You want to even stay in an apartment like that? It's very depressing. It reduces the value. And I'm going to talk about what. So if you buy, say, 40 land for £40, just 20 square foot, I'm quoting around, and the land value will vary. My ideal, as of now, I think land prices would be around £2 to £3 per foot. I will not advise buying anything more than £2 to £3 per foot. Unless, of course, as I said, there are business reason, job reason, right? So let me show what 20 foot of land can give you. £40 investment. So there is, I will show you, right? There's a apple tree in 20 foot land. You can see? And it has more than 40 pound of apple. You can see? Top to bottom, I will show. And this is how much apple we get every day, literally, for next till. I have two apple tree, okay, so it's from two apple tree, and this is the spoiled one. And this is another reason why you want to own your own land, because this is the amount of spoiled apple, right? And this is the amount of good apple. So you see the difference? And even this is not really good. Some of them are still eaten by bugs. So what, how do food producer, like, the trick is not only played by investment bank, the world itself is a trick, as I said. So they apply deadly chemicals and pesticide, which kills you further, which we already talked in another video. So you can see this small 20 foot area, just you can see, right? It's not that much land. It's a very small tree. It's not even that big. So we have spread it for easy collection. You know, you can just pick it up like that. You can see the amount of apple it has. And you can see my other videos, like, you know, everywhere there is apple. Like, you can see every square foot has 3-4 apple. Down below, then up. See, every square foot has how many apple? 2, 4, 6, 8 apple. Every square foot has 8 apple. So this is the amount of returns we get from land, even if you just keep it, like, you know. And most important is, you know, bugs like to eat apple, which means it's safe for you to eat. If it is crystal clear apple like this, that can only happen if I apply deadly chemical. I don't want to apply chemical. My kids are eating those apple. I'm eating. I don't want to give them cancer. What's the point of living your life? And again, see, there is a nectarine plant right in the pot. How much? One, maybe 2 square foot land. And how much nectarine does it have? What about olive tree? See, there is an olive. So, land has huge value. There's another video which we have covered, like, how much things we can get from land. Okay. I hope you understood the value of land. What demonstrated was how just 20 foot of land, which is worth £40, and it's giving you £40 of return every year, revenue. Yes, it is a lot of hard work, but there's automation. It's the age of automation. I'm myself building robots. There's already open source robot. If you, right, there's already open source available. You can just order it, you know, by go to, you know, FarmBots, you know, just search and you can order. It costs $1,300 or something like that. But yeah, even that is too much money for me, okay? So I'm building it because obviously I need it. I have 100 farms. I can't just, 600 is a huge amount of investment. So automation has helped. The biggest cost of this is now automation. And again, I'm not saying you could put a container and leave them. Nothing, nobody's stopping you. You can make electricity from solar panels. You can make biogas, compost. Everything is very easy. Land gives you, you can, if you have the land, you can do 100 things. You can put a factory, you can do whatever you like. In a matchbox apartment, what will you do? So I hope, so this is a paid video. This cost £10. You can pay me, I know it's a COVID period, I do understand that. And so you can pay me whatever you can afford to pay. And I suggest you pay, because one of these, our business is, as I said, a conflict of interest. Like, we are trying to plant trees. So this contribution does go to that, my climate change program we have running. So I saved you your life. I saved you tons of money. And I give you a way where you could potentially earn 10 times or 100 times. So your million could convert to 10 million. Like your $110,000 could get converted to $100,000, 10 times. So that will, your million, billion could convert it to $10 billion. Obviously, more the money you have, the faster you can rise, because then you can buy bigger plots, chunk it out, and you know, so you can do a lot more stuff, because bigger the place, you can install, because the business is going to change. We no longer need big space. Things can be done in a small space, in a small locality. Like, automation is changing a lot of stuff. I hope you understand it. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any comment, any suggestion, please let me know. And please don't consider that you have to make your own investment choices. According to me, it makes no sense, absolutely no sense, to buy, invest in city, apart from other reasons which I discuss. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. Don't forget to subscribe.